just comes down. And look where the bottom of the shoe is, and then his heel bulb. And the snowball pad on.
That's an interesting pad.
Yeah. Something. I know, you're all right. Come on, little nail. There we go. Just grab the other tools. Thanks. So, you know,
a lot of foot to work with.
Yeah, it's good. So right now I'm just trying to do our normal exfoliation, get to the true frog apex, right? Mm-hmm. I know, wait, good boy, I know, take off the mud flaps. Mm-hmm. Got some stretch of the white line here, see that? And some bruising on my head, all right, it's easy to see, back of this foot should be in here, and then the center be in there, right? Frog boob, bar swells.
Right.
Somewhere yep. In there, center line. Sansa, you're in the light, kid. Sansa, come on. Right, and then if we just double it forward. So right about here. Right?
Yep.
And then this is what we're gonna use as the callus here. Right. I'll be okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Yep.
Okay. So let's go for it. Very good. Mm-hmm. I think one of the biggest differences I see between farriers that apply metal shoes and farriers that don't is so often the angle of the trim is different. Although, if you apply metal shoes, you can still trim on an angle, but you might not if you're applying a metal shoe, right?
Yeah.
And if you're applying a barefoot trim, some apply a flat barefoot trim, and some apply a, more beveled. So I'm gonna round through there, right? Good. Okay.
Being mindful of your toe pillars.
Yep, right there.
He brought his toe back.
Yep, yeah. Right there. Job. Maybe. Here, we'll step over here for 1 second. All right, buddy. Let's see if you'll let us use the grinder.
We're going to introduce him to the grinder.
Yeah.
The first time.
Yeah.
Hey, bud.
Good boy.
Thank you.
job, buddies. What do you think?
That's good.
Yeah, right? Yeah. We'll treat his little bit of separation over here. Same over here.
I'm happy with the quality of butt that he has.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, he looks good. Right? He's got a little pocket right there. Yeah, looks great. So we need this to get wider, mm-hmm. but you know, center to center. We left him a little extra toe because the ground's hard right now.
Yep.
But we're a lot closer to where we want to be.
Right, and he left chalk.
So yeah, left chalk.
Just to give him.
Yep.
Catch some of our extra lighting as we come around.
Better?
Yes.
Okay. Good.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Good. Yep. All right, should we do the other one?
Yep.
Okay. How long this one is now. Oh my gosh. Right? Okay. Good job. All right, kid. Yep, good boy. Okay. So same thing. Hang on. So just getting. Oh, there you go. Whoa, good boy. Good boy. Just getting this exfoliated like we do. You can really see how long he is when you start doing that, huh?
Yeah.
Coming out.
Yep.
He's got good concavity, huh?
Yeah, he does.
And that true frog apex down here.
Bar that's popping out.
Yeah. Like that.
Yep. Pens by your foot.
It is. Oh, back there. Thank you. Okay, so back of the foot. The whole frog is underrun and the central sulcus has turned this way. See that? So that's like collapse in the back. He doesn't have nearly enough digital cushion and his lateral cartilages are standing upright. So here's my center right there. 50-50 that. Breakover's gonna be about here. This is gonna be my toe callus right about in there. Helps if I draw my lines straight, but you know, you get the idea. Mm-hmm. Okay, center line. Going off the foot. Good boy. Okay, wait. I know. Good boy. So I do like to just do a nipper run when there's this much to take, right?
Yeah.
Just start getting that toe back. Clearly his heels are weak, so we're not gonna take much there, though probably slipper them just a little bit, right?
Yeah.
So bring that in. Hang on, bud. Hang on. You're okay. I'll give you a break in 1 second. Okay. And, you know, his true white line over here. It's all the way there. So there's a lot of wall here we can bring in, which is good. Okay. Like that. I'm going to do one more. Yep. Whoa. All right. Keep my pillars. All right. Yep. Hand me the grinder. Thank you. Mm-hmm. Here we go. Get a good view of that because it's like a huge pile.
Yeah.
He had a lot of chalk in that toe.
Yeah.
So he was able to bring that toe down.
Lower the toe plane.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Good.
What do you think of that, huh? What do you think of that? Oh, you're a good boy.
It is a good boy. Yeah. Flared out. Like back here?
Yes.
So I want to bring that in.
Thank you. twisty leg.
Yeah, it is a twisty leg, isn't it?
Uh-huh.
He still looks along the lateral side, doesn't he?
Yeah.
Come here.
Good boy.
Same thing again.
You stay there.
Good.
Let me just get this on this side.
Good boy, squaring up.
Better, huh?
Yeah, it's better.
There's only so much we can do when they're transitioning to barefoot, right?
In the middle of winter.
Yeah. But look, he even lands
frozen Massachusetts.
Yep.
Yeah. Oh yeah.
He lands hard over here, huh? Yeah. The left one's not bad. The right one is really twisted. And you can see, look how it turns off that way, right? Mm-hmm. It goes whoop.
It'll be interesting to see, four or five weeks when we're back, where he's wore his break over.
I know. Because his knee is out here.
Yeah.
So, and this foot just goes zoop in. And this one's straighter.
Mm-hmm.
Not quite as twisty.
Does that look better from your perspective?
It does.
Good. I think that's as much as we can do this trip.
Yeah.
Right?
Okay.
Good job, buddies.